This works very, very similar to a computer system, as was given under the stage theory, which is also known as the information processing approach. And this model was given by Atkinson and Shiffrin. And in this theory, they laid down that in a computer, you have RAM and ROM, which is a temporary and a permanent storage. Similarly, in your brain, you do have temporary storage units and permanent storage. That means some of the information is meant for temporary gain. You keep it for a while, you remove it. The other is there for a permanent understanding, and that is kept in the ROM or the permanent storage of your brain, as simple as that. So this whole model compares a computing system to a human brain. So in this, we have an information that comes in, and you have three structural components that are there, which is a sensory component, short-term memory, and a long-term memory. Sensory component is a component which is there for less than a second. That means there is a light coming in, the light gets turned off, still I have some aftershades of the light that is visible. My friend is playing a guitar. He stops playing, still I have the reverberations of the sound that is heard. So it could be visual, it could be echoic or auditory in nature, but it is sensory. It remains for a very short duration. But if I'm paying deep attention to it, it could translate into a short-term memory that I could remember that instance or remember that thing. So according to this information processing model, the short-term memory is encoded as acoustically. That means by hearing, you are trying to have those unrehearsed words getting rehearsed in your minds. And this short-term memory lasts for less than 30 seconds. So that is where we can say it is fragile, but it is less fragile as compared to a sensory memory. The next is a long-term memory. When this short-term memory undergoes continuous rehearsals, I keep on practicing it, might be, it goes into my long-term memory. And this long-term memory is for a lifetime. So it's a permanent storage that could be seen. And the information is semantically encoded. That means I have understood that concept and now I know it. So if I say 2 plus 2 is 4, I know the concept of addition, and therefore if I am asked 2 plus 8, I am able to do it as 10. So that is where is the long-term memory, where you have the concept of encoding it semantically, that is taken into account. So under this information processing model, the first stage is understanding the structural components, which is sensory, short-term and long-term. Talking about the control process. Control process is when you have the information that moves, if there is a selective attention, it would go into the short-term memory. Within the short-term memory, there could be two ways under which you could remember it. The first is a maintenance rehearsal. That means I could repeat that information again and again in order to remember it, or I could do a chunking. That means break down the information into small chunks, and that could be, let's say, I have 3 years that are given. If they are written together, if there is a number that is written together, I can remember it as 1947 and 1949. So I'm breaking down that into chunks and remembering, let's say this is the year of India's independence and this is the year when the constitution was adopted. So what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to break this into two different sections, and this is what is known as chunking. This is what happens in the short-term memory. You have maintenance rehearsal and chunking. Then if I want to move it to a long-term memory, there need to be an elaborative rehearsal. That means let's say I need to understand the meaning of any of the words, let's say memory. So I understand the concept of memory. I might be understand this model or any other model, and then try to have a relation or build on to the existing information that I have, so that this information is semantically encoded and I try to understand this information. So this long-term memory focuses on elaborative rehearsals which take place. Later on, there were experiments that proved that Initially, under the stage model, we focused that short-term memory is encoded is acoustically, however, long-term is encoded semantically. But later on, it was disproved with the developments that came in under the levels of processing model.